Hello, what's up everybody? In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can create one image component with the proper resizing behavior that you can use in your responsive layout. Bear with me until the end of this video. My name is Kia and here is the Kimo. Welcome to my channel. Get sure that our design is responsive. This is kind of a mandatory parameter that we need to consider whenever we design a layout. And the reason is very simple, because we are not sure that which kind of devices our users are using to interact with our product and which size of display those devices has. They could interact with our product using the wearable devices such as the smartwatch, or they can use a bigger screen such as TVs to interact with our product. And if we want to have a responsive design, we need to get sure that the layout itself and every element within the layout going to have a proper resizing behavior. So if we start to resize the master layer or the master frame, nothing is going to get broken and all the elements are going to be shown properly. Image is one of the user interface elements that we are using so often within our design process. Therefore, I decided to make one proper image component with the proper resizing behavior and a fixed aspect ratio. And in this video, I'm going to share with you that how we can do that. Now, without further ado, let's get it started. But if you are new here in this channel, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, get sure to smash the subscribe button right now, like this video and share it with the other designers in your community. So let's open the Figma. To be honest, it's going to be very easy to create image component. First thing we need is a frame with a random size. So just pick up your frame tool and just create one rectangle, one frame with the random size. Let's rename it to image. While we are selecting this frame, we can go to design panel in the fill section and click on the background property or background style that we already have in the fill section, which is the white color. Here in the design panel, in the properties panel, basically, we can switch between different type of styles for this background. For example, we have the solid color, we have gradient, we have pattern, we have image, and we have video. In this case, I'm gonna switch the style to image. We have the image panel, which we have many properties that we can play around with if we have an image here. For now, I'm going to use this as a placeholder. So let's close the property panel and get back to our frame. I'm going to convert this element to component later on. And in this stage, we need to define the resizing behavior of it. For now, if you see, if I select this layer in this frame, and if I start to resize it from the right side by basically dragging the right edge to left and right, the width of this element is going to change. Either I'm going to increase it or I'm going to reduce it. And there's no relationship between this, like basically the horizontal resizing and the vertical resizing behavior of this element. I can change the height and width individually. This might be the behavior that we might need somewhere in our design. However, I prefer to have more standardized and systematic way to handle the images, which is why I usually set certain and fixed aspect ratio for the images and then define different aspect ratios as a default and in a preset that I can use in my design in different places. We are going to select the frame, and here in the layout section, I'm going to set the width to 1 and the height also to 1. I'm doing this at the beginning because I would like to focus on the aspect ratio, not the size. When I put the width and height to equal amount, equal value, then we're going to have a square aspect ratio. Then we can get back to the layout while we're selecting it and fix or lock its aspect ratio by clicking on this item here. Then in that case, if we increase the width or height, doesn't matter, let's increase it to 600. The element that we had, which is this image, is going to have 600 width and 600 height. So we can see that if we start to resize this element, doesn't matter if we do it horizontally or vertically, the height and width is going to kind of maintain the relationship that they have, meaning that we're gonna have the fixed aspect ratio. This is gonna be the first variant of the image component set that we will make later on. But before we go further, I would like to work a little bit on the naming. We all know that how naming convention is important in a Figma when we would like to convert one frame to a component set. We can use slash to create a properties later on when we basically convert this one to the component set. And anything that we write down after a slash is going to be the value that we're going to give to that specific property. For example, in this case, I'm going to write down a square and then slash 1, 1. Basically here I made two properties for this component that you're going to see later on. And I give a value square to the first property and 1 to 1 to the second property. So let's duplicate this frame. And here I'm going to get back to a layout section and unlock the aspect ratio. I'm going to do again the sizing trick that I told you. For example, I'm going to set the width to 3 and then I'm going to set the height to 2. In this way, if we start to increase, of course, before we increase the height or width, we're going to fix the aspect ratio again. We lock it. And then I'm going to increase the width, for example, to 600. And then you can see that now we have one frame with the fixed aspect ratio on 3 to 2. Now let's get back to the naming again. Here I'm going to change the square to landscape, and the 1 to 1, which is going to show the ratio, I'm going to set it on 3 to 2. We can continue making different aspect ratios, but for now I'm going to stop here and show you how we can convert this to component set. The only thing we need to do is we need to select all the frames that we have, and here in this section we can click on this drop down menu. Here we have multiple options to create a component. We can create one component from these two frames, or we can create multiple components from the selected frames, or we can create a component set. The component set is the option that I'm going to go with. In this case, we're going to make one component, which is going to be the image, with two properties that we defined by the naming convention that we had for both frames. Let's, for example, select the square version that we had here. Get back to the properties. You can see that the property number one, the value for this one is a square, and the value for the property number two is 1 to 1. Let's do the renaming on the properties. The first one, I'm going to change it to the not type, actually, maybe orientation, something like this. And for the properties two, I'm going to name it to ratio. Now, if you select the frame number two, or basically the second variant, you can see that the ratio has been set on 3 to 2, and the orientation is on the landscape. We can continue to make different variants at this moment by clicking on this plus button here and do the resizing. I mean, the way you want, of course, better to unlock the aspect ratio to be able to change the ratio of the height and width, and then lock it again, and then define the value for the properties that we have for the new variants. I have already made this component set with the different aspect ratios that are very common in the design world as a variant of it. Therefore, I'm not going to remake it in this video. Plus, I have published this file in the Figma community. So if you want to play around with the component within this file, or if you want to add the image component within your project and reuse it, you can of course find the link to the file in the description of this video. You can add it to your project, you can download it, you can do whatever you want. And now without further ado, let's continue. I'm going to show you how the structure of my component is. Now I have this component set. As I told you, we can create different variants for this component set, and in each variant we basically have the two properties that we defined in a previous step, the ratio or the direction. You can also rename it orientation as we did before, but I rename it now in a direction. I just add two more things to this component, just for the future, which is going to help the designers or the developers to have more visual indication, which is going to show the aspect ratio of the image in different variants as a visual indicator, which I add the visibility of these two elements to a new property of this component set, which you can find it here, show the description. This means if we create one instance of this component, for example, and we select it, we have multiple properties that we can change. The first one is the ratio, which is very straightforward. The second one is the direction. We can say, hey, we want to have a landscape or we want to have a portrait. And we can also turn on and off the description of the image, which is showing the ratio, basically. Our component is ready. We can add this component within our design library and use it in our design. But I want to go one step further and define some more detail for the resizing behavior of the image in general, which might make it more usable when it comes to the designing a layout of the pages. I would like to also mention that you can even go one step further. You can use variables to organize the resizing behavior by defining the max and min width using the variables. I'm not gonna use the variable, but you can do the same thing with the variables, which is more recommended. Now, let's get back to our file again. As I said, I would like to define some sort of resizing behavior for this element within the layout. So I'm going to make a copy of this component, or create one instance of this component. This is a better way to say. Then I'm going to create one new frame and apply auto layout on it and add this instance of the image component within that frame. We can do this by using the combination key Shift A. So as you can see, we create a frame number 3 and we added the image within it. Let's call it image wrapper. This image wrapper is going to basically play the role of the parent layer and parent frame that this component is going to live within it. Of course, if we want to use this image component somewhere in another component, such as a teaser, we can use the same component that we had before. But now I'm going to create one component for only the image itself. So if we, for example, would like to have one image within our page, among the text or something like that, so how this image is going to behave there. You can find this component set within the same file that I shared the link in the description of this video in the Figma community, and you can use it as well. You can add it to your design library. You can copy paste both components that exist within the file. I also wrote a little bit instruction that how you can add the stuff within your design library, but the main part is that you can find this component within that file and use it. Give it a try. Let me know how we can make this component even better. So as I said, you can find the image wrapper component in the same page of the file in the image component section. Let me delete this one that we made. And here in this component set, what I've done is I try to create different breaking points for this wrapper, but I didn't consider this wrapper and the image itself separated. So basically the image is going to follow the same resizing. It's going to fill the whole wrapper. There's a different behavior. You can really decide what you need. You can define the maximum mean width for the image itself. You can define the padding for this wrapper, for example, like this. I mean, top and bottom, you can define different paddings. Here in the properties, you can decide the aspect ratio of the image. Plus you can decide the breaking point of your layout or your image. If you go to my Figma community profile, you can find the file here, if I can point it right, this one. And if you click on that, you should be landed basically in the file that I already showed you. And before you download it, you can also see the whole file using the preview of the page that exists here. So you can go to the image component, check the image component itself. You can also, of course, later on maintain this file and add on top of it and prepare it in a way that you need in your design process. Thanks for watching this video. As I said in the other videos as well, I would like to remind you that I've decided to share your works and your designs in each video that I'm going to make from now on. So if you want to see your design in the next video, get sure to share your works with me. I'm also sharing a couple of design challenges each Sunday, so you can join in our Discord server and you can find the challenges there. You can also work on those challenges and then share your work. Plus, you can get in touch with me via an email or DM me on Instagram. And that was it. Hope it helps. See you in the next video.